In continuation to the last video, we'll take now applications of Cold Rush Learner. Now in this first application, we'll see a calculation of limiting molar conductivity of weak electrolyte. So when you observe here, strong electrolyte, I've plotted molar conductance and concentration, and we are getting what? A straight line with decreasing order. I'm getting a straight line like this with a decreasing order. So for this one, we get a slope, okay, by using what happened? Interception, extrapolation, isn't it? We can get definitely what happened? Molar conductance, we can easily calculate. For this one, no problem. But for weak electrolyte, if you observe here, okay, so I'm taking one more graph here, molar conductance, and I've taken dilution here. This is dilution of both graphs I'm taking. On dilution, what happened? It will, isn't it, increasing. But this I am taking infinite dilution, means what? Very low concentration. At low concentration, this curve, if you observe, it is steeply, isn't it? When you observe here, what happened? It is increasing. What happened? Steeply like this here. But once it is getting like this graph curve here at low concentration, isn't it? Concentration is what here? Zero. Here also concentration is zero. At this point, what happened? It is very difficult for us. Experimentally, it is very difficult for us to calculate the molar conductance value here. So that is the reason. At low concentration, what happened? Isn't it? The conductance, molar conductance here, it is very difficult here. Here also very difficult here. That is the reason we use what? Cold Rush law to calculate what? Molar conductance of weak electrolyte. Now in this question, we'll see, I've taken HAC. HAC is nothing but what actually? Acetic acid, CH3COOH. Okay. Now for this one, we are calculating limiting molar conductance by using strong electrolytes here. To calculate molar conductance of weak electrolyte, we are using Cold Rush law, first application. In that, what you are using? Strong electrolyte. Now, in the problem, the NaCl is a strong electrolyte, salt. HCl is a strong acid, strong electrolyte. NaAc also salt, strong electrolytes here. Now, for HCl, limiting molar conductance is given 426. For NaCl, 126. For sodium acetate, it is given 91 here. Now, what they are asking, limiting molar conductance of acetic acid is a weak electrolyte. It is a weak acid, therefore it is a weak electrolyte here. Weak electrolyte here. Now, these are three are actually what here? Strong electrolytes here. They are what? Strong electrolytes here. Okay, this can be calculated by experimentally. We can calculate this by experimentally, because we are going to get a straight line, we can calculate that one. But weak electrolytes, we don't calculate by using what? Experimentally here. Now how to calculate weak electrolyte molar conductance at infinite dilution? By using Cold Rush law. Let me take how it is. First of all, I am writing here, molar conductance at infinite dilution of HCl is always equal to lambda naught of H plus lambda naught of Cl minus, right? Next, this you take as equation number 1. Then lambda naught m of NaCl, how do you calculate? Lambda naught of Na plus lambda naught of Cl minus, this you take as equation number 2. Next, lambda naught m of NaCl, lambda, this one is actually NaCS3COOH, leave it this one, lambda naught M CS3COONa. What we get here? Lambda naught CS3COO minus plus lambda naught of Na plus. I have written according to Cold Rush law. Sum of the cation anion conductance will be equal to molar conductance of that ionic compound. Okay. Now what I am taking this one as equation number 3. Now what about this? This one lambda naught m of CH3COOH. We get that one lambda naught of CH3COO minus lambda naught of H plus. When you are using for anion cation, use this type of things. Use this big lambda like this. When you are using for what? Anion and cation, use big lambda. When used for molecule, ionic compound acid, you use small lambda like this. Okay. Now this is the equation number 4 you take here. Equation number 4. Now I want to calculate this one. No, this is the molar conductance of weak acid. I need to calculate here. So what I am taking here, so I will do one thing. Equation number 1 plus equation number 3 I am adding, and I am subtracting what happened, equation number 2 from this one. Why? Because in this CH3COO, in which equation you are having CH3COO? Third equation. Okay. In which equation you are having hydrogen? First. This is in first equation. This is in third equation. Now in second equation NaCl is not present in this one. So remove that one. So equation 2 I am removing from this. Whichever is you need. Okay. That you have to add. Whichever is not required for you, that you have to remove here. Now equation number 1 means what? Lambda naught of H plus. Plus what? Lambda naught of Cl minus. Plus equation number 3, lambda naught of CH3COO minus plus lambda naught of Na plus minus equation number 2, lambda naught of Na plus, again minus into plus minus lambda naught of Cl minus. Now if you write here what happened, plus Cl minus, minus lambda Cl minus, minus lambda Na plus, plus lambda Na plus will get cancelled. What will be the remaining here? Lambda H plus, plus lambda CH3COO minus. We are going to remain. This is always equal to lambda naught on M. That means what here? CH3COOH. So we got same equation number 4 we got, no? So now this is equal to what actually? Equation number 4 only we are going to get. Now what is the value for equation number 1? 426. This value will be 426. What is the value for equation number 3? 91. Now what is the value of equation number 2? 126. Now do this one. How much we are going to get here? 426 plus 91. You are going to get here plus 91. That equal to what? 517. Now 517 minus 126 here. Now that much will we get minus 126. That equal to 391. This value will be what here? 391. The answer will be what? 391 here. Okay. In this way we can do.